Now our Facebook login is done. We have tested that we can log in through Facebook. Now we have to see that in this project, this is authorization intensive. We have to keep testing whether the administrator is actually logged in or not. For this, we have to write an authorization filter that can be called whenever a sensitive function is called or whenever a sensitive action method is called. And simultaneously, we have also to add an administrator area so that the code for the administrator that remains in that folder or that part of the Solution Explorer. This will help us make our code more readable, and maintenance is also easier. This is a very nice concept of MVC, which is called the concept of area. And this project will definitely be able to demonstrate how we can utilize this concept of area to bind the administrator's code into a folder in our project. Just confine it to a small folder. And in case you want to add more areas, your main controllers, your main action folders, view folders, they don't get clogged up. I always believe that Solution Explorer should be kept as tidy as possible. Go into depth, like create nested folders, but on top of it, the Solution Explorer should appear very tidy, very simple to see. Just like you see very complex websites, there is a small menu, but when you click on a menu, you see a host of links. So that is what I always believe in case of keeping the Solution Explorer simple. And this concept of areas, this comes very handy in this case. So let us first of all start with writing the authorization filter. Come to Solution Explorer. Right click on the project and add a folder called filters. It's not already there, so we have to add it. We are writing a custom filter here. For that, we'll have to write a class. Right click on the folder, add class, and give it a name, my auth attribute. This attribute should be suffixed to your filter name because we are going to use it as an attribute or as an annotation on our methods and classes. So it is customary to put attribute at the end of the name. The name is my auth, but we are suffixing it with attribute. Compiler knows that it will actually be able to interpret it, just like home controller and home, they are interpreted by the compiler correctly. So the filter name is my auth, but we are putting attribute suffixed to the end. It's customary, we should always do it. Click add. This is our class. This class has to come from action filter attribute. Action filter attribute, we are inheriting from that class. This colon should have been here. Right click and resolve. Most probably dot attribute, I would check out. Should be this one, HTTP filters. No, it's a mistake. It should have been from the MVC one. Right click it, resolve. It should be MVC. And now we can write the code for authorization check here. Public override on action executing, and this we have to override so that it is checked before the action is executed, and we'll write the code here. remove this one and write this one. I'll have to resolve this constants. Okay. This should have been dot. Since we are storing the success login inside a session variable called session underscore logged, if that variable doesn't exist, then we'll redirect the person to the login page. A slash will take him to the outer login page. So this is the only thing that we need to do here. Remember, we are not using forms authentication here. Although if you go by the built-in template of Visual Studio that puts the code for Facebook, also integrates both of them. That is, a user has the option of either logging in through Facebook or through the local database. That's a very complicated code that is auto-generated. And in that case, forms authentication is also there and Facebook authentication is also there. In this case, we preferred the Facebook authentication. So we have to manually just write the code for redirections and all. We haven't used forms authentication in this project at all. If you used forms authentication, then code would have been slightly here, different here, redirect to login page and all that story. Okay. Now we'll have to add the administrator area. We are to come back, right click, add area, and we can write admin is the name of the area that we have given. Click add. This is the code that is added. See, first of all, this areas folder is added, and inside it a subfolder called admin is added. Admin has its own set of controllers, views, models, and there is one file, admin area registration.cs. It is the basic plumbing for registration of the area called admin. You should go through my previous lectures on areas in case you have doubts about it, where I have explained everything about areas. But if you still want to have some connectivity, then in global.asx the first line is register areas. This will basically do the registration process, and this file contains the necessary plumbing code that you can go through. So if you want to like reach an action method inside this area, the path would be admin by controller by action by id. So we'll keep on telling you at various points the significance of this line. So in this particular lecture, we simply added an area, and we also added a filter for authorization that will throw back the user to the login page in case his session variable is not found. So we'll close it right now. Thanks.